Good morning students. Today in this video I will discuss few of the questions related with the fundamental of genetics. Question number 1 is state Mendel's law of dominance. What the law of dominance said? As per the law of dominance, when we cross between one contrasting character, then the character which is visible in the next generation is known as dominant character, and the character which is not visible in the next generation is recessive. Second question is, a pure tall plant is crossed with pure dwarf plant. Pure tall plant is crossed with pure dwarf plant. Draw a Punnett square for F1 and F2 generation. So first you have to mention this is a parent generation. You have to show the cross, as it is said that you have to draw the Punnett square. So you have to draw in this way only. Make 6 boxes, write down their gametes. Its gametes are capital T, capital T. Its gametes are small t, small t. Now, anyone you can take as a male or as a female. Now, have a cross between them, capital T, small t, capital T, small t, capital T, small t, and capital T, small t. This is the F1 generation. Now you have to draw for F2 generation also. For F2 generation, let's draw here. Now, what will be the gametes for F2 generation? We will have a self cross between capital T, small t. This is the F1 generation. And possible gametes are capital T, small t, capital T, small t. And these are the male and female you can mention here. Now we will have a cross, capital T, capital T, capital T, small t, capital T, small t, and small t, small t. Now when you have drawn this Punnett square, after that there is a question, what is the phenotype of F2 generation? This is your F2 generation, and question is, what is the phenotype of F2 generation? Phenotype of F2 generation is 1, 2, 3. There are 3 tall. This is tall because it is a homozygous dominant. This will be also tall because it carry one homozygous dominant character, one dominant character. And this will be also tall. So 3 phenotype would be 3 tall, 1 short, and 1 short. Okay. Your next question is, give the phenotypic and genotypic ratio for F1 and F2 generation. For both of the generation, we have to give phenotypic and genotypic ratio. So, phenotypic ratio for F1, all tall, and ratio will be 1:1. Because sara ka sara ratio jo hai wo all tall plants hai. Actually, all tall plants में आपको यहाँ पे 1:1 देने की जरूरत भी नहीं है. What is the genotypic ratio? The genotypic ratio will be capital T, small t, all capital T, small t. Okay. Now, phenotypic ratio for F2 generation. F2 generation phenotypic ratio is 3:1. So how you have to write 3 tall is to 1 short. And while writing genotypic ratio, you are not supposed to mention anything like tall and short. So there is 1 capital T, capital T, homozygous tall, 2 heterozygous tall, 1 small t, small t. Or you may write like this also, 1:2:1. Next question is, name any one X-linked inheritance in humans. For X-linked inheritance, you may write color blindness, you may write hemophilia, you may write thalassemia also. But in your syllabus, I think color blindness and hemophilia is in your syllabus, so you have to do that. Okay, now moving to the next question. The next question is, write a short note on sex determination. Okay. In this question, what you have to do, that you have to show the sex determination chart basically. So male produce sperm and sperm content XY, female produce ovum and their alleles are XX. So this is a parent generation, and when we have a cross between parent generation, there is a daughter, this will be daughter. So there are two daughters, and wait, so two son, two daughter, okay. So 50% possibility is of daughter and 50% possibility is of son. Next question is, a woman with normal vision marries a man with normal vision. Woman is of normal vision and man is also of normal vision. Now there are two conditions. Women could be normal vision in case of if she is normal, so its allele could be XX, or she could be carrier also, because if she is carrier of color blindness, then also she will look like a normal vision person. Okay, so in both of the cases, there could be a possibility of this kind of allele and this kind of allele also. Okay, let's go for the another one statement. Her husband dies and she marries a colorblind man. Should the type of children that might be expected from this marriage? So we have to do for the, both of these cases. Now, if she is normal, okay, but they have not given any clue for the son and daughter of the first marriage, so there is no need to do cross between this or the male of the normal vision. She marries with a colorblind man. Show the type of children that might be expected. So there could be two possibility. If I am taking this allele and the another husband is colorblind, so there could be a possibility of, let's draw up unit squares, easy to understand. So when we have a cross, she's a daughter, she's a carrier, she's a daughter, she's a carrier, this is a son, normal, and this is a son, normal. Now I have taken the case that the female is having a normal vision and she is actually normal. In any case, she is having a normal vision, but she is actually a carrier of color blindness. Then we have to do some changes. So, carrier daughter, this daughter will be colorblind. Okay, this son will be normal and this son will be colorblind. So 25% son normal, 25% son colorblind, 25% daughter normal or carrier, she will have normal vision at all, and 25% will be colorblind. Okay, so we can say that 50% bachche jo hain, they will be colorblind. Now what is dihybrid cross and how did Mendel perform this cross? Dihybrid cross is a cross in which we take two contrasting character and in this two dihybrid in a dihybrid cross, we took two contrasting characters, say tall plant with yellow seed, short plant with green seed. This is the parent generation. When we have a cross between them, in first generation all the plants are heterozygous and all the plants are having tall and yellow. Capital T for tall, small t for short, capital Y for yellow and small y for green. Okay, now what are the possible gametes? This is the F1 generation. Now for F2 generation, possible gametes. Capital T, capital Y, capital T, capital small y, small t, capital Y, and small t, small y. Okay. Now the next question is, when we have a self cross between these gametes, so generally it is not important to draw it. There is a one question which is important, that what is the ratio of dihybrid. So anyway, if we draw it, how we can draw? Capital T, capital Y, capital T, small y, small t, capital Y, small t, small y. Similarly, we will take here. Okay, now what you have to do? You have to make their combinations. What you have to notice, wherever the capital T is there, so capital T is a dominant character, the plant will be tall, whether it is a homozygous condition or it is in a heterozygous condition like this. Okay, wherever capital Y is there, no matter if it is in homozygous condition, it will be yellow. Even if it is in heterozygous condition, it will be yellow. Okay, green will be there only in case of homozygous small y. Short will be there only in case of homozygous small t. Okay, there is question in your book, I think in exercise. Yes, page number 28, solve examples. Okay, I would like to discuss this question. Question is, study the following problem based on crossing involving two traits that complete given square and question. In a dihybrid cross, when two traits are considered, the number of possible combination in the offspring increases. Suppose that black hair is dominant over blonde hair and brown eyes, black hair, capital B for black hair, small b for brown hair, and brown eyes, blonde hair, brown or blonde hair, capital E for brown eyes, and a small e for blue eyes. Now the question is, complete the square and state the percent of offspring could be expected if we cross father has a black hair heterozygous and brown eyes heterozygous. Father has black heterozygous and brown eyes heterozygous. Okay, and the mother is blonde hair and blue eyes. Mother is having blonde hair and blue eyes. Okay, so what will be the possible gamete? What you have to do for this? In this case, what is the possible gametes of father? Father could have capital B, capital E, capital B, small e, small b, capital E, and small b, small e. Okay. Now, for mother, it will be, in any of the case, it will be small b, small e. Okay. Now, what you can do, you can multiply it once only. Capital B, small b, capital B, E, small e. Capital B, small e, small e. Small b, capital E, small e. And the last is small b, small e. In any of the case, the mother will have same, small b, small e. So the same you could repeat also. So whatever, now what will be the phenotype? Capital B, small b. Capital B is there. So we will consider it as a dominant character. It will be black and capital E is there. So black and brown. Capital B black, and if we have homozygous E, small e, it is a recessive character, we will take it blue. This is brown. S, capital E is there, so it is brown hair, brown eyes. And small b for brown hair and blue eyes. Or might be color could be a blonde hair also. Okay, and that you can repeat. But isme repeat karne ka jarurat nahi hoga. The question will be only this, that what could be the possible phenotype. So this could be the possible phenotype. And what could be the phenotypic ratio? Black and brown 1, black and blue 1, brown and brown 1, brown and blue 1. So phenotypic ratio will be 1:1:1:1. No matter, if we took all those 4 side here, then also it will remain same. Wo karne ka jarurat hi nahi hota hai. Okay, in the similar way, what is the genotypic ratio? Same rahega. 1:1:1:1. Okay. So, let's discuss another question. A woman had normal vision, but her father was colorblind. Okay. Now, father was colorblind and woman had normal vision. She marries a man who is colorblind. Find the probability of the first child. Okay. If father is colorblind, then what are the possibilities for the girl child? If mother is normal, then girl child could be carrier. And this another one will be carrier. Sorry. If mother was carrier, then she could be, one of the girl could be colorblind also. This, do it again. Normal carrier, and she could be colorblind. But it is not mentioned that girl is a colorblind, so we will take the anyhow, the girl will be carrier. So it is clear that this girl will be carrier. And now she got married with a man who is colorblind. A man is colorblind. Okay. Now let's have a cross between these two. This daughter will be colorblind. This son will be colorblind. This daughter will be carrier. And this son will be normal. Now, the question is, find out the probability of the first child being colorblind, whether it is a boy or a girl. Yes, there is a possibility of the child who could be 50% possibility is there, that girl could be colorblind or the son could be colorblind. And 50% chances are there, the girl could be with with a normal vision, or the sun could be with a normal vision. Okay. Next question is, this is an important question. A tall plant bearing red colored flower, is crossed with a homozygous dwarf plant with white flower. This is the parent generation, this is the cross. When we have a cross in first generation, we have all plants tall and red. Okay. Now the question is, give the genotype and phenotype of F1 generation. So what will be the answer? Genotype for F1 is capital T small t, capital R small r. Phenotype for F1 will be all plant tall and red. Now the next question is, give the possible combination of the gametes from the F1 generation. Possible gametes capital T capital R, capital T small r, small t capital R, and small t small r. Next question is, give the dihybrid ratio and the phenotype of the offspring of the F2 generation, dihybrid ratio. Dihybrid ratio will be 9:3:3:1. And the phenotypes are 9 tall and red, 3 tall and white, 3 short and red, 1 is a recessive character, that is short and white. So what you need to learn, maximum are dominant, that is 9 tall and red, minimum are recessive, that is 1 short and white, and 3 are tall and white, and 3 are short and red. Okay. Our next question is, a hemophilic man marries a hemophilic man marries a carrier woman. Man is hemophilic, and hemophilia is a X-linked disorder. So we will put the abnormality on X chromosome, and the female is carrier. Okay. Now the question is, find the probability of their offspring to be hemophilic. Okay. Let's have a cross between them. This is a parent generation. So it's better to draw a unit square. Actually, it looks very clear and you don't have any doubt. So this is male and this is female. Okay, let's have a cross between these two. She is hemophilic. Son is also hemophilic. Now, in case of female, if it is present on one X chromosome, she will consider as a carrier, and son is normal. So 50% children could be hemophilic and 50% could be normal. Okay. Next question is, no, this we have done. So more or less this kind of questions are there, and I hope you can do these questions now. In your book and last exercise, moreover though I have discussed in last video, that there are certain unit 2. In insects such as grasshopper, and cockroach, the sex of offspring is decided by the presence or absence of X chromosome in the sperm cell. So in that, female is, in some of the insects like grasshopper, female is homozygous, it is having XX chromosome, while in case of male, one of the X chromosome is missing, that is zero. Okay, so it is female and this one is male. So if we have a cross between them, this will be female grasshopper, male grasshopper and male grasshopper. Now the questions are, the female is homogametic? Yes, female is homogametic. Homo means same, gametic means gametes are same. The male has two chromosome? No, male has only one chromosome, that is X chromosome. Zygote with XX chromosome develop into a male? No, zygote with XX chromosome will develop into a female. Zygote with XO chromosome will develop into a male? Yes, it will develop into a male. Now similar question we have, in certain birds, fishes and reptiles, we have two types of X, Z and W chromosome and only one type of sperm. In case of some birds and reptiles, egg contain two kind of the gamete, that is Z and W, and sperm is having only one kind of the chromosome, that is the Z chromosome. Okay, so again, if we have a cross, ZZ, ZW, ZO, sorry, one kind of chromosome means they are homogametic. ZW, ZZ and ZW. So questions are, the female is heterogametic? Yes, female is heterogametic because it has two different kind of gametes. Male is homogametic? Yes, true, male is homogametic. What is the composition of zygote which develop into a female? Female ka zygote hoga ZW. And what is the ratio of male and female offspring? 1:1, because male are there, 2 are female, so the ratio is 2:2 or 1:1. So I hope all these questions I have discussed. Still, if you have any doubt, you are most welcome. Keep reading, keep practicing and keep asking. Till then, goodbye, take care.